Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to see everybody this morning. Welcome to Holy Family Parish for the celebration of this Sunday's Holy Mass. Advent reflection materials are on the table in the narthex. If you have a picture of a loved one on the remembrance table, please pick the picture up after Mass this morning and bring it home. Thank you. The Advent penance service will be held this Thursday, December 2nd, starting at 6 p.m. There will be four priests available to hear confessions. Please come to prepare your heart and soul for the coming of the Lord. This Advent season, the Endries Family Foundation will once again hold Salvation Army Red Kettle Match Day at Econo Foods here in Brilliant. Please see the bulletin for details. Today is the first day of Advent. Today we enter into a new liturgical year, and today we also enter into the third phase of our parish renewal, where we focus on prayer. In today's gospel, we hear Jesus warning us not to become drowsy from anxieties of daily life. As we enter into the celebration of this Holy Mass, let us be vigilant at all times and pray that we have the strength to overcome the trials of this life. Our opening hymn is in the Gather, number 395, O Come, Emmanuel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We are beginning the season of Advent. The word Advent means the coming, and we are waiting for the coming of Christ into the world and into our lives. If God is coming, we should have a great desire for Him and this great urge to want to run forth to meet the Christ with our lives. So to prepare ourselves and to celebrate as a community, let us pray as we light our first Advent candle. Lord God, Your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessing upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call
sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, we may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell secure. This is what they shall call her: the Lord our justice, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is number 39 in the Gather Book.
Oh,
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, may the Lord make you increased and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father, at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his holy ones. Amen. Finally, brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that as you received from us how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know that what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on earth nations will be in dismay, perplexed by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will die of fright in anticipation of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these signs begin to happen, stand erect and raise your heads, because your redemption is at hand. Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of the daily life, and that day catch you by surprise like a trap. For that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times, and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent, and to stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Think of that time when you really wanted something. You think about it, you save the money, you plan about all the things that you're going to do about it, and there's an excitement that grows within you. Then suddenly you finally get the item. After a couple of days, it ends up in the closet and you never think about it again. I think that's a common experience for many of us for the things that we have in our house. You see, human beings desire to have things. But the problem is that our desire for things is always greater than the thing can provide. That's because human desire is infinite. We have a desire for the infinite within us. But the only thing that's infinite is God himself. Think about that for a moment. We were created for God. We were created to know and love God. That means that in the end, our desires can only be satisfied by God himself. St. Augustine even said, "My heart is restless until it rests in you, O Lord." Today is the first Sunday of Advent. This is 4 weeks that our church uses to prepare for Christmas. Advent means coming, where we look back at how God came into the world 2,000 years ago. We look forward in our prayers, "Come, Lord Jesus, come," as we ask God to come again in the future. But we are also looking at how God comes into our life right now. Our gospel today is describing this coming of God. And it ends in that very interesting passage by saying, "Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength." What the gospel is saying, to have God come into our lives, for us to be ready, we are called to pray. Advent and Christmas are times to focus on prayer. Over this next year, our parish is doing a parish renewal, but when we are focusing on the five essential elements to the Christian lives, these are five things that should be part of every Catholic life. We're trying to make living our faith as simple as we can. We're focusing on each Christian, each of us here, rather than the church as general, because in order for our church to grow in Christ, our parish to become faithful, we must be filled with faithful, strong Christians. As a reminder, those five essential elements of the Catholic life are daily prayer, going to Mass and receiving the sacraments, actively working on growing in holiness, financially supporting your parish, and sharing your faith with others. Today, we are beginning the section of bringing Christ into our lives, that theme of Advent and Christmas, by looking at the importance of daily prayer in the life of the Christian. Think about it again. If our deepest desire is for God, and it is only in God that we will know love, that we will know salvation, that we will know that joy in its depth, then daily prayer, daily contact with God is essential to being a Christian. How can we win the spiritual battle if we never even enter the fight? People who are not praying will often ask, "How do I begin? I don't even know where to start with prayer." I want to remind you, in its essence, prayer is very simple. It's not complicated at all. In its essence, prayer is just talking to the one you love. God loves you, you love God, and prayer is just to talk to him. It is only in prayer, that time that we spend with God every day, that the relationship with God will actually grow. But yes, prayer is very simple, but it is also very deep and profound. You will have experiences in prayer that will change you. The first goal of all of prayer is intimacy with God. Think about this as the way what we should be thinking when we kneel down. Prayer is when you fall in love with God. But again, if you don't have a prayer life, you may be asking, where do I start? Where do I begin? When I was small, my parents taught me how to pray. And again, it was very simple. We knelt by my bed every night. We said the act of contrition, the Our Father, the Hail Mary, and the Now I Lay Me Down to Sleep. It was very simple, and I never missed it. Didn't take a long time. It was, again, very simple. This is how I would encourage you to begin your prayer life. First of all, set a time that you never miss. It could be the two moments of right around bed. When you go to bed, pray. When you wake up, pray. Offer your day to God. Setting a time is probably the most important thing, because then you will develop a habit of prayer that you will always do. Growing up, I never missed my night prayers, even when I went away. I can even remember my first day in college. I went to the UW-Madison, I got my new roommate, I met him, we talked for a long time. It finally came time for me to go to bed that night. I knelt down by my bed and he looked at me and said, "What are you doing?" I said, "I'm praying." For the first couple of weeks, every night he teased me about kneeling by my bed and praying, as if that was a strange thing to do. Then it went from teasing to asking questions. And then from asking questions, by the end of the year, he was kneeling by his bed praying every night. If you only pray when you feel like it, then you probably will not pray very often. Now, I prayed every night before bed, and I had a set of memorized prayers. And to begin with, it was a very short thing. It wasn't a very long thing. I developed more different other ways of praying later. But those simple memorized prayers were the heart of my prayer life until I was in my mid-20s. So if you are just beginning a prayer life, and you're just saying, "Okay, it's Advent, I'll do something," and you just want to start praying, start with memorized prayers. I would suggest getting a good prayer book. Keep that prayer book right next to your bed so that you can look through it and get a number of prayers that you like. When I say memorized prayers right here, I'm referring to any prayer that is written down. Any prayer that is written down that you could memorize. You can just read memorized prayers. I'm just using that phrase. Or you can commit them to your memory and actually have them really be memorized. You could get these prayers from a prayer book or from Scripture. We get memorized prayers from all over the place. First of all, there are those basic prayers, the sign of the cross, the Our Father, the Hail Mary, the Now I Lay Me Down to Sleep, the act of contrition. These are the prayers that every Catholic parent should have taught their child by the time they were 4 or 5 years old. But then there are other great prayers, the Te Deum, the Anima Christi, the Angelus. These are also great prayers to pray on a regular basis, maybe even have them memorized, and they are found in every good prayer book. Another great source of prayers, Scriptures. There is an entire prayer book in the Bible called the Psalms that has 150 different prayers dealing with every situation that any human being could ever experience. You could just take those 150 prayers, find the ones you like, and bring them into your regular prayer life. Or another thing, just maybe pray one psalm every single day. And then every 150 days, you'll have finished the entire Psalter and begin again. I love the Psalms because they're great to do in a group or in a family where every person does a different stanza and you just pray it together. Another source of memorized prayers that we often don't think about, hymns, our songbooks. Our hymns are nothing but sung prayers. You can take a songbook and just sing and sing your prayers. For that reason, I love that I live alone sometimes, because I just sit and sing and sing and sing. And if I was living with other people, it would annoy them something horribly. Or you could even take your own hand and try to write a prayer. I am a real advocate for memorized prayers. Yes, there are other prayers. We're going to explore all different ways of praying throughout these next couple of weeks. But for beginners, I like to encourage memorized prayers. Choose 10 or so prayers or psalms that are very important to you. Work on them. Even try to commit them to memory, if at all possible. But you may be asking, why do I like to memorize prayers? Shouldn't it just be spontaneous from the heart? Yeah, we'll talk about that later. But first, a memorized prayer is always with you. You don't need a book. You don't need an app on your phone. When you're alone or when you're struggling, you have the words you need without having to look them up. Your prayers are always there. Being in the car, standing in line at the store, late at night, when you, all of a sudden you're alone and you just want to pray, you have the words. You can begin to pray. One of the struggles that people have when they just begin praying, so if you're one of those people, I have never prayed, I want to just start now, is we don't have the language of prayer. These memorized prayers will actually give us a language which we can then use in our spontaneous prayer, our other types of prayer. Yeah, these memorized prayers gives us a language. You are God, we praise you. You are Lord, we acclaim you. You are the eternal Father, and all creation worships you. Wow. Another thing that memorized prayers do is it takes the focus away from me. I love to just talk with God. I think that's a wonderful way to pray. But when I talk with God, I notice that I'm often talking about my life, my thoughts, my fears, my struggles. That's important to bring to God. If we have a relationship, we should talk about my life. But memorized prayers then take our focus away from just me and focus it on God. Those memorized prayers are often, "Our Father who art in heaven," or "Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit," or again, from the Te Deum, "You are God, we praise you, you are Lord, we acclaim you." Memorized prayers focus us on adoration of God. Another thing that I love about memorized prayers is it allows us as Christians to pray together. There's a unity when we have our prayers memorized and we can say, let's say our meal prayers, "Bless us, O Lord." Let's pray the Our Father together. Let's pray the rosary, and we have all of the prayers memorized. So again, parents, teach your children to pray so that we can pray together. There is another good thing about memorizing prayers. The act of memorizing becomes a prayer itself. Think about how you memorize a prayer. You take the first line, "You are God, we praise you. You are God, we praise you. You are God, we praise you." And you memorize it. You think about that line. You incorporate it. And then you go to the second line, "You are God, we praise you. You are Lord, we acclaim you. You are Lord, we acclaim you." And you memorize that second line. You think about the words. And then you go to the third line, then you string them all together. Just the repeating of the words over and over again as you are memorizing a prayer becomes prayer itself. So if you're ever saying, "What should I do for prayer today?" take a psalm and say, I'm going to memorize this psalm as my prayer today. And you just say it over and over again. And here's how it's going to work. By the end of your prayer session, you'll have the prayer memorized, but you'll forget it by tomorrow. So tomorrow, when you take up that memorized prayer and you say, and you memorize it a second time, after the second time, there's a good chance you'll have it memorized permanently by then. The act of memorizing itself becomes a prayer. My parents taught me my prayers when I was very young. So any parents or grandparents, teach your children to do the same. From the ages of, say, 3 years old to 6 years old, your children are memorizing machines. If you just pick 20 or so prayers or psalms or passages and you work on them with your children, then your children will have access to those prayers for the rest of their lives. As a child, I was always science-minded, which means I was always asking questions. I was always looking for answers for things. And one of the things that I began around eighth grade, I actually had the thought, is prayer just for kids or is it an adult thing? And I actually began to think about that. At that time, I knelt by my bed every night and I said my prayers. And I began to think, am I too old to do this? As I was contemplating this, one day I was walking past my parents' bedroom. And when I looked in, I saw my father kneeling by the bed praying. He had his head down, and I just stared in and watched him praying. I didn't know who he was praying for. I didn't know what prayers he was doing, but I saw my father in prayer. And at that moment, for some reason, my heart was just filled with pride and joy that my father was praying. I realized at that moment how important prayer really is. It was indeed an adult thing to do. It was a Catholic thing to do. And I noticed that I needed to continue to pray. Pray for my family, pray for my community, and pray for the world. For the next few weeks here in our parish, we will be learning about prayer. I would hope that you would begin to pray daily at home. Make it part of your family life and part of your private life. Take some ideas that you hear from these talks and try them. Experiment with them. If you have to, go back and re-listen to the homilies online again so that you can get an understanding about prayer. We as Christians should see prayer as an adventure. Prayer is a spiritual adventure into the very life and depths of God. As we come to know and love Jesus Christ, we will become conformed to Christ. Prayer will change us. I just want to end by listening to what Jesus said today in our gospel reading. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength. We are Christians. Let us publicly profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophet. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Each of us have experienced God's love in so many different ways in our life. Knowing that love, let us turn to him with our prayers and our petitions.
For an increase in religious vocations, especially in the Diocese of Green Bay, may the Lord bless those discerning priesthood or consecrated life with generous and open hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a world that will raise up servants who protect the vulnerable, especially the aged and the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle with questions about their faith, may the power of God's grace bring them peace and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit help us increase and abound in love for one another as children of our Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people of Holy Family parish boundaries, both the living and the deceased, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God in heaven, we come before you with these prayers and all the prayers we hold deep in our hearts. Grant them through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please join in singing the offertory song, O Come Divine Messiah, number 401 in the Gather Book.
Oh.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the loneliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you. Lord will bestow his bounty, and our earth shall yield its increase.
The communion song is found in the Missalette, number 229, The King Shall Come, number 229 in the Missalette.
Thank you.
Would those bringing communion to the homebound please come forward? You are being sent from this assembly to bring the word of God and the bread of life to the sick and the homebound members of our parish family. We ask you to go to them with our love, with our care, and with our prayers. And we ask you to do this in the name of Christ, our Lord and gentle healer, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you very much. Since I wasn't here last week at the end of our talking about our supporting our parish financially, I would just like to take a moment and thank everyone who turned in your pledge card. That is very important for us as a parish. It helps us to budget, to have an idea of what will be coming in. We think that's very important that you take that thought and that prayer to fill that out and send it in. So many of you have done that, and I would just take a moment to thank you very much for that pledge. It's very important to us. I also mentioned in my homily how important a good prayer book is. I would encourage you to give them as gifts at Christmas. Make sure everyone in your family has their prayer book. We can't expect them to pray if they don't have a prayer book or scriptures. If you're curious, I wonder what prayer book Father Tom recommends. I put it on our Facebook page, both my personal one and on the parish one. So if you're curious which one I would suggest as a very simple, compact, but thorough prayer book, it's right on our Facebook page. Also, if you are more contemporary, there's a lot of wonderful Catholic prayer book apps out there for your phone. One of the more popular ones called Laudate, or those who don't speak Latin will call it Laudate. Use the resources that we have and work on that prayer life. Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 865 in the Gather Book, Soon and Very Soon. Mm-hmm.